day, many fish. It's the 8th of July, 2019. And the old computer has been giving me all kinds of problems, so, you know, it is what it is. But I can't help but revisit this whole 4th of July, Washington, the Lincoln Memorial, all these things. It was quite literally a giant ritual designed to conjure up and deceive people to get their spirit focused on make America great again, patriotism, power, war machines, being the biggest, baddest, greatest, planting flags on Mars, okay? This is the stuff that is just a giant deception. It's all shiny and pretty and it sounds so good. Get rid of that Federal Reserve. And that's great. Don't get me wrong. He has been placed there by God, I'm telling you. But he also has his own free will. And that man, I am sorry, but it's obvious to me that he is definitely not walking and living in the Holy Spirit of God. It's just an obvious thing to me. Could I be wrong? Sure. I'm not accusing anyone of anything. I'm just pointing out the obvious, okay? Now, you got to remember that this event that they had in Washington, D.C., it's so blatantly in your face that you just can't get around it. You know, and I only show you these things because if you don't know Jesus and you're looking at these things in the world and you're starting to understand that you're dealing with something far deeper than just a few bad apples. This is a spiritual war, and you're beginning to see it right in front of you. And if you're not in Christ, it's scary, and it's confusing. And there are a thousand things out there that will tempt you spiritually to try and fill that void and that fear inside you, because people come to realize there is a spiritual element to this. And believe you me, these dark powers and principalities, they know full well that it's a spiritual war. And so they suck you into these shiny new ideas and these shiny new beginnings. It's going to be different this time. We're going to change everything and drain the swamp. Well, the swamp is just putting on a new lipstick, basically. That's all it is. Because this ritual, check this out. The Lincoln Memorial, the reflecting pool, the obelisk, the dome, and in here where the Arch of Baal was proudly displayed. I showed that the other day. Well, this Lincoln Memorial, this is just the stuff that comes to me, you guys. This literally represents, with its 12 pillars and its altar set back in there, it's the altar of Pergamum. That's exactly what it is. The staircase, everything, it's all right there. And Lincoln is the sacrifice, okay? Lincoln was the sacrifice, assassinated, right? And there's a whole bunch behind that as well. But what I'm getting at is this rally simply was getting that energy focused on the military and getting the bad guys, because we're the good guys. We're the God-fearing country that sets up these gigantic temple altars right in front of everybody and keeps it a secret and tells you, see, if someone's keeping these secrets, let me tell you something, they're not your friend, okay? And because you're in a spiritual war, it's eternal, and that's all they want is for you to die in your sin without the saving grace and knowledge of Jesus Christ. That's their number one objective. Do you think this is all an accident? That's all I can tell you. Why is the Washington Monument sitting in a vesica Pisces? Because it represents the two becoming one. This is Satan's kingdom on earth. See, he's just mimicking and mocking God's salvation plan, convincing mankind that they can get their salvation through their own enlightenment, through their own knowledge and ascension. And this is what they're bringing in, the new age of enlightenment, okay? And the ones that will lead the charge are the Jews who say they're Jews, but they're not. These are the ones that are influencing Trump the most. Of course he was placed there by God, but only to give us a reprieve. This is a literal gift from God to come to Christ now before the switch is flipped, because it's going to be. Trump promises to bring in new banking, clean the swamp. Well, he's going to bring in new banking, and it's going to be the prelude to the beast system. Okay, the 5G, all of these things Trump is bringing in. Do you understand? This goes all the way back to the beginning of the country. Why do you think they enshrined Washington, okay, with these two death figures, essentially, with Exodus Octoprobat, okay, on the Washington Arch, mind you? Think about this. You need to understand. What's written on that arch literally means the outcome justifies the deed. Now, what was the outcome that we see pertaining to this right here? We know what the outcome was. The two became one with a giant blood sacrifice. This is what they're doing. They're bringing in their new world order, and they're giving you the perception that they are destroying the old, dark, ugly new world order and bringing in the new, enlightened new world order. Okay, it's just another carrot to dangle in front of you. I'm sorry to be the one to tell you guys this, but this is obvious. It's obvious. With the dome, the whole thing, the apotheosis of Washington. I mean, come on, you guys. Ascending above the clouds, again with the Isaiah 14. And not only that, this was my random Bible verse this morning. Galatians 3. 11 through 13, the 311, the numerological USA, but that no man is justified by the law in the sight of God. It is evident, for the just shall live by faith. So why do you have the outcome justifies the deed with George Washington on this arch that was strategically placed? I'm just telling you guys that this is all here. It's all coming. You remember Trump's visit to the Vatican? Interesting, the image that they're right in front of. Christ. The Christ consciousness is what they will convince you is coming into fruition here. You understand? It's a deception. And they place him right in the Vesica Pisces, of course, right where the Washington Monument sits. All dressed in black, in order to pay respects to the Black Pope. Okay? This is the deal. I'm just trying to square you away and let you understand that you're in a very deceptive spiritual war. Washington, D.C. is set up to represent the temple itself of Solomon, of course. The Lincoln Memorial, the altar, the brazen sea, the reflecting pool, Joaquin, Boaz, the positive, the negative, the male, female, represented by the obelisk in the Vesica Pisces. This is what all of this stuff is. And the Lincoln Memorial, in their own words, is a temple enshrined forever. Abraham. Before it was Abraham in the Bible, was Abram. So they had to have Abram tanks there. He was told to sacrifice his son Isaac on the altar of fire. But you need to understand these things so you don't fall for these traps of freedom and justice, because it's not going to come by any man, only by Jesus Christ. I mean, look at what Trump did when he visited the Vatican. Incidentally, when he visited the Vatican, guess how long ago that was? Go look at your date calculator. As of the 4th of July, it was 770 days since they visited the dragon dressed in black. Come on, you guys. Are you just plain flat out kidding me? May 25th, 2017, 770 days from July 4th, 2019. And as of July 11th, 7/11, it'll be 777 days. Just to give you a heads up is more or less what I'm doing. That's really all I'm trying to tell you. This is no joke. This is the real deal. And this deception is growing and growing. and you need to be in Christ. It's the only way to truth. I'm just telling you. I hope you seek him today if you don't know him already. It's that important. So, peace and grace to you. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,